Yo, what up? It's time for more Bayonetta. And me getting frustrated at Bayonetta. Because, man, this game's hard. Hope everyone's been having a good day today. I had a phone call with my mother. And heard all about my youngest sister having troubles in school. And that's pretty much all I did today, other than eat a bowl of cereal, I guess. So in case you're wondering why I don't often have a ton of interesting stories to tell about all the goofy stuff I get up to, that's that's my average kind of day. And nobody wants to hear about that. But I'm telling you about it anyway, to kill time, to give people the opportunity to show up before I actually get into the gameplay. But that's enough stalling. I'm switching over. I'm remembering that I forgot to capture the game again. Ka-chow! There we go. Took a while. Chapter 12, The Broken Sky. I got 50,000 bucks.
You really want to make a deal with the devil? Relax. I'm just fucking with you.
This isn't Hi-Fi Rush, 0 out of 10 stream. Yeah, it's not Pizza Tower either. All these dang cool games came out today, and it's like, I don't really want to get started with any of them because I'm gonna be busy next Thursday. Lieutenant Kilgore Alt. A production version of the original Lieutenant Kilgore, Colonel Kilgore. Meh. But yeah, Hi-Fi Rush seems really cool. I do appreciate that it has a streamable audio setting of just like, yeah, we turned off the 9-inch nails and stuff, so you can show this game to your friends. I'm thinking I'm not going to be available this coming Thursday, but the Thursday after that, I might check out... The Thursday after that my birthday? Hang on. No, the Thursday after that is not my birthday. The Thursday after that, maybe I will check out Hi-Fi Rush or Pizza Tower. Because both of those games seem pretty great. The Dead Space remake comes out tomorrow. Yeah, you couldn't pay me to play the Dead Space remake. I'm sorry. From my understanding, I like a lot of the gameplay mechanics of Dead Space, but everything about that game is very bad for me. So, I'm not going to be playing it. But I'm happy for the people that are excited for it, because I've heard that it looks pretty good. Love the Bayonetta game so much. I also like Bayonetta a lot. I like Bayonetta 1 less than I remember.
Excuse me, sir. May I have my glasses back?
Huh? Oh, yeah.
But it's still pretty good.
Cereza, how did you get such magical glasses?
The glasses aren't magic, silly. I can see the monsters without them.
Monsters? Not quite. So, has Bayonetta, I mean your mom, been fighting these big bad monsters for a long time?
Mummy is a witch, and witches protect people and are very strong. When I grow up, I'll be strong too, and I'll protect my mummy.
Wait, you think witches do what? No, forget it. No point in arguing with a little kid. I'll manage on my own.
That wasn't a dab.
I'm sure you will.
Mummy!
Shit.
You never cease to amuse me, Cheshire. I suppose that's your next target? This is yours, little one. You didn't cry while I was gone, did you?
Oh, it's got the band-aid.
Good.
Bayonetta, no matter how I ask, no matter how many times, you always say the same thing.
Come now, Kitty. You know it was
a misunderstanding. You're so stubborn, you know that? My father, he was a journalist too. In fact, he was twice the man I could ever hope to be. He was obsessed with one case his entire career. A case so bizarre it took over his life. They could have made a movie of the details. The followers of darkness, the Umbra Witches, and their light world counterparts, the Lumen Sages, controlling everything with a power known as the Eyes of the World. Then, the Light and Dark clans suddenly disappeared from their medieval home in Europe. You may be familiar with the town. You're standing in it. Welcome to Vigrid, 500 years later.
Yeah, I've been reading the journal entries, buddy.
500 years.
Each clan, working at the behest of the powers that be, sought to lead their fractured world towards peace. They both possessed an eye said to have the power to create history that they used to oversee the world. However, their spirit of cooperation did not last, for amongst them, a pair of young star-crossed lovers conceived a child that sent the clans on a path to ruin.
All you can hear is Ben 10. I'm getting Persona 4.
Jail, and the man exiled from his clan. However, the child remained with the Umbra, raised as a black sheep even amongst the darkness. Since the balance between light and dark had been lost, both clans spiraled into decay. Legend had it that the two eyes could be united to control reality itself. And this legend fueled ambition and desire, leading to a myriad of battles between the clans. In fact, it led to their mutual destruction. My father was mocked for buying such a fairy tale. However, I believed his story. And I believe it more than ever now that I've found you. The memory of the clan lingers on, despite the passing of 500 years. What on earth was my father searching for? And why did he have to die for it? I have to discover the truth with my own eyes.
Father!
That's why I haven't given up my chase for it. Or you. The head of the HatVod group, the multinational that dominates Vigrid, recently tried to sell an enormous gemstone on the black market. If he isn't selling out in the open, it means we're going to have to acquire it by other means. And that starts by sneaking onto that jet.
Huh.
Mummy, are you looking for something?
I am.
How did you lose it?
Little one, do you have anything you really like? Something really important to you?
Oh my god, you can see your nipples pressed up against the front of the outfit.
Yes, this. I love it.
Where did you get this?
You gave it to me, Mummy, for my birthday.
When you love something, never lose it. Understand, little one? You must keep it safe, close to your heart.
Cool. Oh right, this is an action game.
Teresa! Damn.
I'm sure he'll catch up. Military Transport Valkyrie Interior. So, regarding the hand cramps, the thing is, I don't usually get hand cramps. What? Oh, it's one of these. Great. Bayonetta is one of the only games that actually gives me any kind of, like, hand or wrist soreness. His attacks are seeming kind of familiar somehow. Take me a bit to get back into the groove of things. Ooh, red hot shot. Someone's given this jet the Duke Nukem Mighty Boot, except it's white! What could it mean? Oh god. Immediately lore. The Valkyrie Military Transport. Unfittingly for a city of its small size, Vigrid plays host to a large military airbase. The roar of takeoff and landings that engulf the city are not that of passenger planes, but of incredibly large military transport jets known as Valkyries. I have been aboard American military transports many times in an official capacity and seen many of the finest jets up close. However, none compares to even a distant view of a Valkyrie. The size distance is clearly evident, like the difference between a crow and an eagle. To think that something that large could fly in the sky is something that I still cannot believe, despite having seen it with my own eyes. Of course, there is no doubt that the cargo it carries is quite dangerous, so seeing the plane's huge mast literally drop onto the runway during landings causes me to feel a deep anxiety, as though the weight of the plane were literally landing on my shoulders. It leads one to wonder what the authorities were bringing into this little principality with all the extreme security they have in place. Vigrid has long since cut ties with most ties with the outside world and has reared itself within its own unique culture. Perhaps it is this influence that led to the Valkyrie's equally unique design. At a glance, one can see the deep religious influence on its design, or perhaps the view is simply our deference to a plane born of technology so different from our own that we simply nod our heads in astonishment at the miracle of flight. Imagine flying a plane and not checking that the weather is flying boots and fists. Oh, bird! Wait! I couldn't catch the bird because I was doing a big stupid mace flail. Give me the bird. I got a gold for that! I took forever. Oh boy. Time for Uncharted 3. Brought to you by Subway. Gotcha. Got hit a little bit, but pretty good otherwise. Gellerhorn Defense Initiative. Boy, more plot. At the center of the man-made island of Aladel Sol, there is a display of sheer military force unimaginable for the likes of Vigrid, a display whose menacing power I cannot shake. While there is very little public face to these efforts, if my information is correct, the military spending there rivals that of even the greatest powers of the world. Moreover, amongst the towers of enterprise and government, other buildings stand as anti-aircraft countermeasures. These buildings, a strategic defense initiative known as the Gellerhorns, are anti-aircraft SAM missiles and have been placed in the four corners of the island. What in the world would cause a small place like this to install such dramatic defenses? There's also word that the Americans are involved in the armament and expansion of this military complex here. It is said that the Ithaval group is undertaking some sort of next-generation energy research and thus had traded rights to this technology for added force of arms. It is not a wholly unbelievable story. Seeing all of the military takeoffs and landings in Vigrid, I don't want to think their destination is actually the place I call home. Right, the Gellerhorn is also a thing in Destiny 2. That's a Norse mythology thing, if I had to hazard a guess from the name. Alright, since the rockets have travel time, they're not as good for dealing with these guys. Oh wait. Aha! That's why you have weapon sets. No, my combo! There's a thing in there. I want the thing! What is it? It's an Alfheim! You know what? Sure. Ready for Doom? Link Heaven to run power plants? Oh yeah, I don't remember the name of the power plants they used in Doom. It was just like, have we found a portal to hell on Mars? And it's really good at giving us thermal energy or something. Hell is really good at boiling water. Use Witch Time. Defeat all the angels before the time expires. Enemies can be defeated during Witch Time. These, like, you can only defeat enemies during X timing or mode or whatever. They're so frustrating because if you try and do an attack at any other time, it deflects. Oh my god. Just hit me. I know so little about Destiny 2 meta. Not trigger Witch Time. Oh, that was in one? Let's see. Goes to show what I know. Wow, what an exciting fight. I got a platinum for that? Okay. Oh, don't make me think about having to do my taxes. God. I do have to do that. Sometime relatively soon, and I'm not excited. There's still an IRS equivalent in Canada. I wonder if the self-employment tax situation up there is any worse. It didn't give me a ranking for finishing that fight. Am I missing a dude? Ah! Huh? I was Canadian, but not... By the time I had to worry about taxes, I had already moved to the States.
Why so glum? Something troubling you? Only your constant fretting over my state of affairs. I've no time to play games with you. No need to take out your stress on me, Bayonetta. It's clear you're worried for the girl.
Woo! Rival fight time.
She is now. My, aren't we attached to our precious little one? Do you like it when she calls you mummy? You're absolutely delusional. If I leave her, he'll never shut up about it, and his whining is twice as irritating as anything the child could muster. You've quite the tongue when it comes to curling round the truth. And what about you? What are you hiding? Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think these might mean something to you.
Statue.
I've no need for worthless junk. I am well aware of my task, but you have forgotten that I do not need your help.
God dang it.
It seems your little friend is gone forever.
That's pretty cool.
Fill them. Fill your eyes with hatred. Accept your violent fate. Accept it and earn the left eye. Prove you deserve it.
Every moment of this encounter is so over the top. To use a healing item. Phase two. Oh my god!
Feel your fear.
She summoned a motorcycle! I'm too cool for your motorcycle tricks to work. Yeah, multi-rocket kick. Oh, she's got too many iframes. Counter. Compare the speed of her punch rushes. I lost. I was mashing so hard. Yep, double platinum and then frickin' iron.
Cereza.
Rescue the child.
Not yet. She isn't ready.
I'll have to go outside. That hurts me. The mash expectations of this game are so ludicrous. What did you miss? We had a rival fight. And I had to use a healing item, but... And I lost a mashing competition, but otherwise, I'm doing okay. Treasure of the Clans, the Eyes of the World. Several hundred years ago, the now-vanished clans of the Umber Wishes and Luwin Sages stood as overseers of time immemorial, thriving from their remote European base known as Vigrid. However, their reign quickly came to a close with a violent war that ended their mutual destruction. Their war, lasting for 100 years, saw the witches and their campaign of assassination push them to the brink of victory, yet the people's fear of these powerful women spawned the witch hunts, and eventually both clans vanished into the ether. Long serving the powers that be, it is said the clans did not use their power to interfere with history, but rather protect its passage. We are told that they carried out these duties via use of their treasured Eyes of the World. Yet what that statement means is anyone's guess. What is clear is that the clan's very existence was closely linked to the historical change, so much that even kings and emperors feared the clan's power. There were two Eyes of the World, one each controlled by the witches and sages, which when used together were able to carry out their stated task of overseeing. To prevent the power of these eyes from being used for nefarious purposes, they were equally split, and the clans prohibited interrelations to maintain the balance of power that existed between them. The irony is that the grand war that led to the clan's destruction was sparked by these very treasures. After their downfall, the Eyes of the World suddenly disappeared. Information about them is extremely limited. What sort of item were the eyes? What shape did they take? All of this remains unknown. The black markets recently saw a large gemstone come onto the market bearing the name the Eyes of the World, though it may be under a different item under the same name, or even a mafia scam meant to gauge market reaction. There is no proof that the ancient treasure was actually a gem, but there is reliable, albeit troubling information regarding the treasure of the CEO Ithaval Group. CEO of the Ithaval Group, it is said that he is in search of some unknown item for his development project in next generation energy, but whether it has any relation to this matter requires further research.
Crying. know the rules. No cockroaches or crying babies.
Rescue the child.
Hold on tight, okay?
Okay.
Oh. Oh, damn it. Oh god, no. It's not just rescue the child, it's protect the child. It's even worse. Whoa, what happened to my audio? Why did the game mute? What the fuck was that? What the fuck is this? What the fuck is going on? Okay. Don't use the red hot shot! I'm stuck in the void! I'm gonna restart the game. What the fuck was that?
Say.
Oh, darn, looks like you're performing quite poorly. Here, why don't we use this healing item on you?
No.
What? I got trapped in the void and the music stopped working. Who? By what? Oh, the bad water was getting too high. Okay. Wait, no. I need to put her up there. Otherwise, the water thing is gonna happen again. Not even close. Plenty of health to spare. So many of my fights in this kind of game, it's just like, oh, incredible combos, great speed with finishing the fight. Oh, you got hit like 8 times though. Oh. Yep, there it is. I'm not hitting anything. It's so hard to see what's going on. Didn't even get a good combo there. Ooh, missed three optional fights. Not a stone. I'll take it. Angel attack!
Ready, fire!
God damn it. God damn it.
Round over.
That's enough to buy a red hot shot. The cardinal virtue of prudence. That sounds like a boss fight to me.
I'll be right back.
I gotta strike a pose for this sick boss fight.
Another talkative type. I don't think I've got time to entertain your blather. I'd much rather hear it straight from your boss. The witch hunts.
Rest, I think.
Damn it. Of course there was a lollipop. Oh boy. Time for the surfing boss fight. You know that Divine Beast, Breath of the Wild? Yeah, this game did it first. Pipe train! Except instead of a giant elephant, it's a giant whale shark. Toronto.
Don't touch me.
climax. Ah, dang it. Yeah, I don't want to deal with a big spider either. Again. I hit it. Oh god, now I have to go through this phase before I get another try. Try this again. There we go. I don't know why it didn't work any of the other times. That's it? All that fucking effort for that? Oh, don't do this again. Oh my god, what a time waster. Climax. Oh, this again. His wings. We have revealed the orb. Woo! The orb. Don't send me back out. rude. Final climax. Just tell me what button I'm mashing.
Why you would want this stone, it would look absolutely terrible on you. Much too flashy.
Yoink.
Aboard, Cheshire.
Oh, fucking hell!
Mummy!
I told you I'd be right back. Shouldn't you be, you know, flying this thing? I'm a bit occupied at the moment.
Mummy! Well, so much for the subtle approach. We might as well have speakers on this thing blaring Ride of the Fucking Valkyries.
Come now, we're VIPs. You know, nothing says you've made it in life like a private helicopter.
Then welcome aboard Air Luca, Flight 001. This is your captain, Luca, speaking. Fasten your safety belts, as this may be a bumpy flight.
I don't know if I would put on a seatbelt. I think I would want to be able to get out of the helicopter as soon as possible, because that thing is going down for sure. Gold!
Bam.
I'll take a gold. No item bonus. Luca Joestar. Oh god, it all makes sense. Ah, hey, I still got 70, though. Well, I beat the boss that I just was on, and I got a gold rating. I didn't use any items, and no continues or anything. So that's pretty good. Isla del Sol. I got 100k, I could get another accessory.
Take care of my babies, will you? Some people may have a thing for the 45s, but to me, these are the real works of art.
Alright, there's also the treasures. What do I have access to? Are there any accessories that I particularly care about? Oh, right. This one gives you the parry, but it costs 200,000 instead of just 100,000. Heal by taunting. Sure, I'll save up for the parry, I guess. I could get another healing item or two, but I have a bunch of red hot shots at this point, and I think that's probably fine enough. Hype train!
You're really not going to like what comes next. I hope you know that.
Don't tell me. Air Cheshire has awful in-flight entertainment and horrendous food.
Think about it. Those things that downed the jet aren't just going to let us land on their island. You think we can just say, hey, we're here, and they'll bring us a cake? Things look good from up here. But the further down you go, the harder it is to not notice the reality.
Cheshire, look.
Oh, I'm looking.
Yuri Lowenthal, there's missiles.
Oh, fuck me.
Welcome to my fantasy zone.
Get ready.
Oh, you thought fantasy zone was just a joke? No. It's time for the fantasy zone minigame. It's even playing the song! I know all about Fantasy Zone, thanks to Yakuza. Which I didn't know about the first time that I played this game, so this level is so much Whoa! Motion sickness mode available. I'm gonna have to fight a big, weirdly segmented dragon at the end of this. Yeah! I'm flying to the moon. Oh, not yet! We'll get there. There we go. That's the move I'm looking for. And back to it. I should play through a stream, probably, Star Fox 64. It has been so very long since I played that game. Woo! Fingers are getting sore from holding down the button for so long. I got a gold medal. Ripping off Digidoggy, look. I like old games too. That is old confirmed. Younger than you. And yet, distressingly older than a lot of people that I know. I'm 28 years old. I'm almost 29. Turning 29 in less than a month. Still haven't hit the big 3-0 though, so I'm basically a child. Oh boy, another dragon fight. Except this time it's two. Oh, and it's playing the fucking Fantasy Zone sound effects for ineffective shots, too. The folks at Platinum sure do love their arcade games. Sol Cresta looks really cool, but I'm not a big shmup fan. Ow. Ooh, ow. Oh my god. I'm getting hit a whole heck of a lot. Get greedy. Oh god, immediately back into it, huh? You're really gonna make me hold down the shoot button this entire time and make my controller vibrate for 10 minutes straight. Woo! Oh my god. I'm hurting. I still got some level to go, huh? This section is so long! Dang it. This is gonna take forever. Oh, right, I can shoot faster if I mash the button. Yeah, that'll be so much better. It did reduce the time that I had to continue doing the thing. So there's that. Oh, thank God.
It's brilliant, Mummy!
Yeah, why was that part so long? I could have beaten the real Fantasy Zone game in that time. What? I see you too were riding a missile.
Welcome to Isla del Sol. Island of wealth and power. Jean, if you've made it this far, that should be enough. You're back to your old self. This is where we finish what was started so long ago.
A friend of my enemy is also my enemy, be it witch or sage.
The Lumen Sages. They were our counterbalance as overseers.
Lana. Oh my God.
Between us, there was a law that was never to be broken. It stated that the intersection of light and dark would bring calamity to this earth. But 500 years ago, a child was born in clear violation of this tenet. That child was you.
500 years ago.
The disaster this caused sent the clans into a spiral of chaos that continues to be felt to this day.
The moon!
You The half-breed of light and dark are at the center of that chaos. Allowing you to continue to exist is a danger that cannot be accepted. When the eyes of the world are within our grasp, the power of creation will be awakened. That is why the left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. The left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. Bayonetta, it is time that this is brought to an end. That you are brought to an end.
You did it. It is our charge as witches to protect the treasures of the clan by any means necessary, even if it means burning every inch of this island to a crisp.
I'm really beginning to hate missiles. You know, I have no idea what the hell you girls got going on here. But you don't mind if I take this off your hands, do you? Get in, Cerecita.
Mommy.
Time to drive the truck off a building. And he's dead.
Theresa. Bayonetta. Time is of the essence. This can wait no longer.
You didn't even need the remote to be shooting those missiles that entire time. Got so much health bar. Fuck. I waited a little too long. Alright, phase two. Great. Umbra Witch Jean. Now it's the real rival fight. You can tell because now she's got the opposite color from us. There's just a super slim timing window on it. Oh my god. Stop shooting missiles at me. Oh, she's got the sword too. I hit it. Dude. I'm hitting the button. I'm hitting the button, I swear! Or the button combination, rather. Whoop! Fucking damage! Another location change. Yeah, maybe the fact that I'm playing it at 60 FPS instead of 30 like the game originally ran at. Counter! Yes! I was ready for it. I did it! I took so much fucking damage, but I did it.
Now it's decided. So it is. The fear is still not gone from your eyes. Fear? Memories you've held for 500 years are the source of your fear. They cloud your vision. But now, you've accepted your fate. That is how you bested me. That is why you possess the most beloved of Umbran treasures. That is why you possess the left eye. We fought for this stone, and because of it, everyone died. That gem brings back so many memories. Why the left eye? Our treasured left eye. I will not stand for the wild ambition of a treacherous Lumen sage. It's our age-old balance. Your path ends here. Do not fear your fate. Stand, Theresa. In the innocence of our childhood, we used to play together as friends. But as time passed, perhaps even my eyes were clouded with fear. We were. Do not fear your fate. Stand, Theresa. Stand and open your eyes. For with every truth, there is another one to be seen.
Oh, the Carla Nescar.
Sean.
Yeah, well, the rival exploded. What a shame. Oh, wait. I thought you exploded too.
Hey, is it over? What? It's not like you don't scare the shit out of me all the time.
Cereza. I don't know whether to shoot you or to take you to Vegas for good luck, Cheshire.
Give me more credit than that. If you must know where L-U-K-A Luca is concerned, there's no such thing as luck. Only skill. You didn't expect me to trust bitches. I mean, witches, did you, Bayonetta?
How's the little one?
Out like a light. But okay, other than that. What about you? You really think I'm gonna let myself be seen in public with a girl looking all beat up like that?
Oh. I look dreadful, do I?
Huh?
You'll have to learn to wipe that stupid look off your face, or I'll never let you keep chasing me around this world. Got that? Luca?
Now that's more like it.
Oh my gosh, she said my real name! Oh jeez! Oh man. I really made it now. Yeah.
Oh, what a day.
Oh right, that also included the stupid the rail shooter section. Oh. Damn it.
Round over.
All right, give me another red hot shot.
A tower to truth.
I love how the game never addresses how convenient everything is. It's just like, oh, yeah, no. We needed to be here next. Welcome. So the exploding building took us over here.
It looks like someone's expecting us. Awfully nice of them to roll out the red carpet.
Luca, you need to get one thing straight.
Yeah, I know. I won't look after you, so don't screw up. I got things under control.
Let's go. Stay next to me, little one.
Daddy?
What?
Daddy! It's Daddy!
Daddy?
Of course, Mommy. Can't you hear him?
Uh-oh.
Okay, Daddy, I'm coming. And I'll bring Mommy with me.
Little one, wait!
This way, Mommy!
Little one!
Cenicita! Bayonetta! Damn it!
All right. Time for the DMC 3 tower climb. To raise her own mom. It's a little complicated. Silver. It's hard to get combos on those dudes, because as soon as you're out of witch time, they have the flaming effect, so that they deflect you. No! Why more flaming enemies? I hate it. These fights. Oh, it's the end of the game. Better get good at the combat. Better get better combat, idiots. God, I hate the flaming enemies so much. Seems like some sort of control terminal. All the cables are connected to the giant pillar in the center of the room. Oh, I'm not allowed to just fly over there. Are there any secrets? Are there any extra bonus secret fights? Well, that's nice. A little extra healing will go a long way to getting the grabby hands off the edges of the screen. The lingering hitboxes. I was doing pretty good on that fight until the lingering hitboxes started to bully me. these are the hard mode versions of these guys. At least they're not on fire. He was just high enough in the air to avoid all those attacks. What a jerk. Use your E-tanks. I don't have any E-tanks. I don't have any healing items. I just have the red hot shots. Can't you craft healing? I don't think I have enough crafting items. Used them all up. Aww, I got no damage, but I didn't do a good enough combo. Dang it. Do I have... I have enough for a small healing item. But I'm pretty sure it's more efficient to save up for the big one. What is hitting me? Oh my God, another fire fella. You buy the ingredients with Rodan. You can buy healing items from Rodan, but I need to find the shop. Oh, I'm not in boss fight mode, so I'm not allowed to hit him. There's a platinum. You'll love to see it. Time to use the gun! No, I didn't want to get out. trying to set up my mash, and I was having trouble. That hit me! Bullshit. I don't know if turret sections were ever hot. The game certainly had a lot of them. The Xbox 360 was a turret section's paradise. Oh my god. The area ahead doesn't seem to be of use, and there's no sense trace of Cereza anywhere. Don't go that way, you're not allowed. Oh boy, been a while. Island in the Sun, Isla del Sol. The Ithalol Group, once a medium-sized IT company through acquisitions, has broadened its business base and become one of the world's leading conglomerates. Their base of operations is on a man-made island off the coast of Vigrid, known as Isla del Sol. Isla del Sol was initially constructed to concentrate Vigrid's urban functions in one area and facilitate expansion. However, its true function is to funnel enormous power to the ruling authorities, creating an autonomous region under the Ithalol Group. Control in order to facilitate the creation of a theocracy. The CEO of the Ithalol Group, claiming to be a descendant of the Lumen, not specifically Lumen Sages, just the Lumen, has used his economic and political strength, even exploiting the faith of the people, to bend Vigrid to his will. That is how he was able to influence the construction of the island, as well as the city's urban planning, and match his own religious views. Buildings are lined up as if they are an enormous spiral being drawn towards the center of the island, a symbol of the trinity of realities known as the Cosmos of Chaos. Among these urban structures, there are SAM-equipped strategic defenses known as the Gjallarhorns, of tall buildings creating a skyward barrier that is nearly impregnable. At the center of the curtain of defense lies the Ithalol building, the heart of the Ithalol conglomerate. I've been able to obtain important information regarding the building itself. While it may be the outward symbol of the city's wealth and pride, the inner sanctum of the building is home to the advanced energy research that the Ithalol CEO is secretly using as leverage that he hopes will allow him to remake the world according to his vision. It sounds absurd, but I've seen things on that island so strange that I believe it now with all my heart and soul. You're fighting corporate Christians? Ah, America. I see. In spite of the building crumbling, security shows no signs of crumbling. There are no signs of responding. There are no alarms, it's almost too quiet. They simply blocked off areas that aren't in use. Is this a section that I'm allowed to, like, backtrack and find bonus fights, bonus content? How far back is it gonna let me go? I'm curious. Countless containers filled with a red liquid are suspended from the giant shaft. It seems each container's contents are being pumped up to the top of the building. Ah, and they're shaped like Iron Maidens. Vaguely human-shaped. Not suspicious at all. Green? No. I need one more green crafting item in order to be able to afford one of the big healing thingies. I want a big green lollipop. Red. Nothing. No time to go back. I have to find Cereza. Nothing. God damn it. I don't have any red hot shots left. If I take a single point of damage from any source, I am dead. Make the jump at the end of the start. The end of the start. Aha! Now I want to see. Oh, there's breakables over there. Oh. I was excited because something new, and then I realized that the something new was one of the bonus arenas. Witch art! Aha! I have a little bit of health now. Alright, I'll try the Elfheim. Yes, thank you, Cereza. Witch time disabled. That's fine. Oh, that's not fine. I can't even, like, do the kick to fire off the second rocket if they get too close. Oh my god. Oh my god, and you lose health if you accidentally kick him. Ah! Dodge offsetting. I'm not good at it. Whoa. Do it. Yeah, do it. Damn it. Facing the wrong way. No, he flew into my fucking kick. What was that? Come on. Camera is not particularly conducive to this strategy, but I almost got there last time. Okay, well. Hate when I think they're going to get knocked back and they don't. Yeah, fine. If you get too close while doing the breakdance, that'll hit you. Just end me. Target that guy, and it was a bad idea to target that guy. God, please. What? How was that not aimed at him? I lost my magic because I accidentally slightly grazed him with my sword. I hate the Alfheim so much. Three more tries. Three more. Attempt number one. Out of here. A little too close, a little too fast. Very surprised that did not get me. Torture attack while I have it. Okay. There's more? Oh. Well, I'm not finishing this. I'm done. Not going to clear this Alfheim. That's a shame. Skill issue? You're correct. I'm not going to spend an extra dozen hours getting good enough at this game to rank well in the Alfheims. Sorry. What? Huh. Okay. There one more potted plant over here? There was not. But the potted plants throughout the building should be respawned, and maybe I could get a heal off of one of them. Nothing yet. Still got a couple more potted plants to get through. Still got a confused camera to deal with. Take the magic, but it's not really gonna help with the problem that I'm currently experiencing. Well, what a shame.
world.
No. God damn it. Fine, I'll use the lollipop. Another mini boss rush, huh? Karate chop. Got a gold for that? That did not feel particularly deserving of a gold, but I'll take it. Suspiciously high technology, all surrounding this big cool statue. Not weird at all. Oh. I will take a shop. Buy a red hot shot.
No matter how much you ask, I'm not putting a chainsaw on your arm. So what do you want?
Limit one per customer. Oh, right, I can get more health bar. That's something to spend my money on. Alrighty! I guess I could also buy a lollipop. I am now substantially beefier. Oh right! The health bar like does a little wraparound thing. Multiple health bars obtained. Surprised I didn't realize what sooner that I could buy more health items. I knew, I just wasn't thinking about it. Free the bird. Catch the bird. God damn it. Give me the bird. Oh, I just quit trying to deal with you idiots. Don't force me to.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. All right. He was telling me all about how pissed he was, and I was unimpressed. Bird. How did that not catch the bird? Give me the bird. Time for lore. Ithaval CEO 1. The Ithaval group holds complete control over Vigrid, planning the city and arming it to the teeth, all while using rhetorical flourishes to conceal the conglomerate's many dark facets. The company's vast political and economic power has created an island held as the symbol of modernity, Isla del Sol, and placed its headquarters at the symbol's very center. At the conglomerate's top stands a man said to be the descendant of the long-departed Lumen, a man who has earned the adoration of the people, Balder. Balder is, as they say, a mystery wrapped in an enigma. If he is truly one of the descendants of the Lumen, that would mean the blood pumping in his veins has been pumping since their extermination some 500 years ago. However, even if you look back through the decades of Vigrid's records, there is no knowledge of anyone with a Lumen lineage. Furthermore, if you search for information on his hometown, schooling, work history, or family, you find that it's all been forged. There is no record of his life before Ithaval, nor are there any stories of unimpeachable veracity. It seems he has been hiding details of his life ever since his birth. I have already chronicled many unprecedented military expansion and turbulent movements related to next-generation energy research taking place in Vigrid. However, a man who has for years, or even decades, hidden the facts of his life is now at the very pinnacle of power of a conglomerate with literally earth-shaking might. The question begs to be asked, what is this man capable of? Part 5 villain, yeah, kinda. This is all a giant statue of a goddess. Constructing something this big within the building makes me think all the equipment around this place were not simply religious effects it seemed to be. Time to pole dance around the giant statue of God. Zoop. Pole dancing on God? Why is everything on fire around here? Oh no! Wait, actually, pick it up, please. Thank you. Part of a magic upgrade. Part of a health upgrade. Lore. Ithaval CEO 2. There remains one thing that worries me about Balder. There are rumors that he's been partaking in the game of the Lumen Sages, in other words, feverishly hunting any remaining Umbra witches in order to facilitate his next-generation energy research. It is hard to believe that a member of the clan thought to have crumbled away 500 years ago still remains unbeknownst to the world at large. However, when considering they are purported to have wielded massive power as overseers of the world, the word that the self-styled sage Balder is actively seeking a witch forces one to have major qualms. And of course, while in... While the sound of research into next-generation energy is incredibly attractive, the marvelous ascent of Baldur, as well as his startup company and his control of an arsenal of armament and fortifications, has all been conducted under a cover of total media control. Could one honestly say that all of this secrecy would be needed for something that has peaceful uses? And another troubling sign is the ease of which one can obtain information regarding the Ithaval conglomerate of late. It may just be my journalistic sense, but I feel there's a possibility that Baldur is intentionally leaking information. If we make that assumption, that leaves me with no way out. Ever since I began covering Vigrid's transformation in the dark shadow behind the Ithaval group, I have been on an inescapable crash course with the truth. Even if it was a trap, I must overcome that trap and get to the truth. I am hell-bent on doing so. Looks like there's only one lore book left. I didn't want to do that. Anyone could have seen that I didn't want to do that. Turn into a bird! Turn into a bird! Fly up! Fly upwards! Please! Please! Aha! Where's the rest of verse 12? I want to finish this fight. Ah! There we go. That was still a gold medal, are you serious? How low the standards have fallen. No, I wanted to turn into a bird. So bad at dodging the ball's attacks. Climax the balls. Button I have to mash. I think it's Y. Oh right, it's this. Ooh. Hype train. Kaboom! I'll take a gold. Gold's fine. Oh, another one of these. We seem to be getting suspiciously high up into the air. Thank you. No, don't turn into a bird. God damn it. Boss continuing his tendencies of having long periods of wasting your time. Ah, gotcha. Oh god. Please no instant death. Yeah, the Red Hotshot healing more from having the bigger health bar is quite the boon. Time to go in the orb. Orb! Oof. So many items used. No game overs, though. Angel attack! Yeah, let me see your fucking first playthrough Bayonetta rankings. Give me a red hotshot. I don't want you to stream this game because you probably put like 50 hours into it. You actually got practice. I played it once, like 5 years ago.
Check this out. What are you buying? Heard that in a game once.
You haven't gotten past the first boss. What? I don't believe you. Seen the bosses and cutscenes, but not actually played it? That's crazy. I don't believe you at all. Next up, you're going to say you haven't played Metal Gear Rising either.
What follows those living in the light is nothing but the profound, empty darkness. Born from the shadow that grows longer as they approach the brilliant radiance. To truly see, your eyes must be open to both light and dark. Don't you agree, my dear child?
Mummy's here! Mummy's here! Mummy!
Little one.
You've arrived, my dear, sweet Cereza. My, Why the grim face, my dear? As a child, your smile was warmer than the sun.
So, you are the last of the Lumen Sages.
I am indeed. My name is Balder, but if you so choose, you may address me as Father. There is much you have forgotten. It has been 500 years since we last met. If your memories were still intact, this would have been a much more emotional reconciliation.
How did you get the girl?
Where shall I begin? We, the Lumen Sages, and your Umbra Witches, have long been the overseers of history, each bearing witness with their own eye. This is how our universes existence was preserved. However, for 500 years, you have been exiled from the world's affairs. You are the left eye of the eyes of the world.
Could you dispense with the riddles and just tell me what these sodding eyes actually are?
Your years of slumber have caused you to forget many things, even as we stand on the verge of the resurrection of the Creator. The resurrection of Jubileus. There is but one way to return your epic of forgotten memories and open your Eye of the Overseer. Your uncorrupted eye had to be exposed to the history it could not see. Ah. Your battles, your struggles, everything you've experienced in this town has been a stepping stone for your enlightenment. It has all been done for the left eye.
I've had enough of your philosophical pretensions. I won't ask again. Where did you get the girl?
Your question has been answered. All this has been done to awaken the left eye. For that, you had to see yourself once more.
Oh my God.
You are truly beyond salvation, Sage.
Ah, salvation. Such a curious word. I mark the path to salvation with light. However, no matter how brilliant that light grows, the darkness within the human heart grows even darker. Light, dark, and chaos between. Three realities, once split, shall be brought together to create a new universe in the image of the old. To these ends, leading to the Festival of Resurrection 500 years ago, I fanned the flames of terror, spurring on the witch hunts. However, despite the people's belief in the return of Jubileus, the Creator, the left eye was out of reach. Since then, I have devoted myself to this town's prosperity. And now, it is time for my preparations to bear fruit. Jubileus will be resurrected. We will become the eyes of the world, and a new universe will take hold.
I could never call the man behind this nightmare father.
Great speech, big guy.
Luca.
Getting a bit ahead of ourselves, aren't we, Mr. Big Shot Ithaval Executive? Salvation, light. You take this entrepreneurial philosophy a bit seriously, don't you? But it's all diarrhea of the mouth, if you ask me. History is littered with famous genocidal figures, just like you. Or, should I say, infamous genocidal figures.
You must be Luca, journalist extraordinaire. I must say, I'm truly impressed you've made it this far, child. Like father, like son, I suppose.
What?
Luca, Luca, Luca. Your father had problems with my philosophies. It's fine to investigate, but when malicious rumors start to spread, I must see to it that they come to a stop. For being kind enough to ascertain that my long-lost eraser was at the bottom of some lake, I granted him his final wish and accepted his permanent resignation.
You bastard!
You are of no use to me. However, I am not without dignity.
Save him, Bayonetta!
I allow you to die in the same manner as your father.
You'll be fine.
Well, I guess my plan has gone right out the window.
Oh!
Such a shame that sacrifice had to be made. But if destiny is not fulfilled soon, this tragedy will be repeated ad nauseum. Speaking of tragedy, I suppose you've met Jean. While she sealed you away and kept you from trouble, after falling into our hands, she's been incredibly useful. Although her distinct lack of obedience required a bit of mental reprogramming. Her tragic end led you directly to me, just as Blair. The time for awakening the left eye is soon. Fear not, my dear, sweet Cereza. That's it, Cereza. Do not fear your fate. Stand tall, my child. Realize your true potential.
He's got sage time.
Cereza, we are one, my child.
A little creepy. Father Balder, the Lumen Sage. can't fucking see with all his peacock feathers. Jump. Okay, there we go. Why did they allow this CEO to have orbital lasers? Lana, shh. No spoilers. Chief Evil Officer. Boy, my rating for this fight is going to be miserable. Supposed to be the climax attack. What? Okay, if he's just throwing the building, that's more reasonable. I hit it. I swear I hit it. Try this again. Got him this time for sure. Ah, darn it. I'm running out of demons here, dude. Every single one of his attacks has priority. Oh, bitch. I hit the button. My computer is too good to be good at Bayonetta.
Don't fuck with a witch.
Kapow! Ooh. Oh shit. Gotta dodge the glass.
Hey, Jubilus, the creator, grace you.
We got the child back. Child, who is me?
I've got to give you credit, Bayonetta. You never cease to impress.
You haven't seen the half of it.
I've seen enough. Well, that about wraps it up, huh?
Not yet.
Man, must have so many back problems. He's a young guy. He'll be fine. Time to fix the timeline.
Mommy. Daddy.
No need to be afraid, little one. The nightmare is over. Everything was just a dream. You're a strong little girl. There is nothing you cannot overcome.
Mommy. Did you find it? What you were looking for?
Yes, I found it. So don't you worry anymore. You just keep your treasure safe too. Sweet dreams, little one. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words.
All right. Fix the timeline, beat the final boss. And then died of a heart attack.
When you love something, never lose it. Understand, little one? You must keep it safe. Close to your heart.
I'm not afraid anymore, Mummy. No matter what, there's nothing I cannot do.
Bayonetta! What's happening to you?
And now it is done. The right eye oversees the light. The left eye oversees the darkness. Two eyes to oversee the world. It was never the woman known as Bayonetta that I set my sights upon. It was you as a child, Cereza, that I saw. For she was the one who saw the world through innocent eyes, and she was the one who could give rise to a new history. It was her energy that could awaken the left eye. This has all worked out splendidly.
All according to Keikaku.
Let us begin, Cereza. The time is at hand.
What, you thought orbital lasers and throwing entire buildings at someone was enough for the finale of this game? Come on. Let's be realistic here.
Now, the resurrection of Jubileus shall be completed. We are the eyes, overseeing the world. We are the eyes, overseeing a new era, a new reality, to which we will devote ourselves eternally. Jubileus, the Creator, grace all of its creations.
Oh no! Control the left half of the giant statue and punch the right half? That would be pretty great.
Silver.
Obviously, God has to be the final boss. She's buddies with Kirby. That's just how it works. See, Meiji gets it. It might kinda be a little bit Devil May Cry 4. Maybe just a little. Goodbye, Bayonetta. Time for the epilogue, Requiem.
For these halos, and maybe I can buy a ticket to space. Always wanted to be a bald space marine. What can I do for you anyways?
Am I allowed to buy another red hot shot? I'm not. I'm also not allowed to buy any more lollipops, so I guess I'll get Moon Pearl? I'll buy the little healing items, I guess. I don't think I'm gonna use them, but just in case. I hope I don't have to use them. What's with the Kappas? Come on. I'm good at video games. Awooga. Warning, warning, God has been resurrected. We are now firing God into space. Please maintain your distance. God is coming. No, God is leaving. God is exiting the atmosphere. Sick-ass motorcycle.
Thank God. There's still time.
She had the cool gem. I let her break the mind control.
Left eye, our treasured left eye, will never fall into the hands of another. It is the pride of the Umbra Witches.
Time to play as the rival! We gotta shoot at angels while riding atop a gigantic skyscraper that is also a rocket that is shooting off into the atmosphere. On a motorcycle. I keep cutting the dodge timing way too close. Need to dodge a little more preemptively. Oh yeah, and the top of the rocket is God. Yeah, gotta do some Kingdom Hearts jumps. Let's go. I ain't got time for you losers. I'm out of here.
Nah, Jean. You provided me with many blessings. The one and only authentic left eye. Merely seeing it must stir jealousy within you. Your body must yearn to feel a new universe form around it.
I have no intentions of gazing upon the left eye. I am here to reclaim my Umbran sister.
So we were flying to the moon, but he piccoloed the moon. Ah, here we go. Gotta climb up the giant god statue. In space. Destroy the moon just so the debris might stop you. Yep.
At last, the Trinity of Realities will know their real ruler, and time will begin anew.
Theresa, wake up!
Are you insane? Light and dark. Unless both eyes remain, the universe will lose its balance and face another Armageddon.
Then this thing should have slept for eternity. Now you must wake up, Theresa. Theresa! Theresa! Damn you! Open your eyes!
Jean.
Theresa, you aren't the person I sealed away 500 years ago. You have the strength to overcome this and fight. Finish this!
Goodbye.
My, oh my. No one can control Jubileus now. His power is too intense. Light, dark, human. All the strife. All the struggle. The Trinity of Realities. Wrapped up in a vortex of creation!
Well... God woke up. And it's bad for us.
Rest, my friend. I'm off to get that black cat.
I recall having a lot of trouble with this boss. No! Not fire mode. Right, ice mode. Oh, right. Still not allowed to touch the floor. Touching the floor is still bad. Oh my god, that's so much fucking damage! Are you joking? Well, there goes an entire health bar worth of life. Fine, I'll use a healing item. Oh, that's not enough healing at all. Just let me fall, but just let me interact with the fight, please. Oh, oh. Little disoriented. I'm not exactly sure what I'm what the game expects of me in that circumstance. Yeah, but sometimes, like, you're supposed to use the small rocks to get to the other big rocks, but, like, there was some clarity lacking. Thing about this fight. No, I can save it this time. Oh, bitch! I was landed on it. Alright, what do you actually expect me to do here? The jump prompt lasted for so little time. Oh my god. Fucking finally. I'm a child. Partner punch. God damn it. Man, breaking up the shell. Nope, stop it. Stop. Climax. Go, go, go! Climax! You know what's bigger than God? A demon! Limit exceeded, big bang bonus! We punched God's spirit out of God. No! Now we have to avoid all of the planets in the solar system with God's spirit so that it gets burnt up in the sun. Shit. Asteroid field. Better watch out! Whoa! I can see my house from here. Whoa! Yeah, if you fuck up that section, you have to start from the beginning of the boss battle. I was thinking about hitting Earth as a goof, but it was not worth it. We did it. We killed God.
Unbelievable. We managed to stop this abomination, and it's still going to destroy the world. Jean!
Of course she didn't die. She still had her motorcycle.
Come now. You're one of a kind. If you die here, who's going to save the world? I'll send you home, even if it kills me. Now, let's finish this.
You and I are going home together. John, we're both one of a kind.
Now those are the eyes I've been waiting to see.
Time to destroy God's corpse so it doesn't destroy the planet. John's over there on the other side helping out. A little higher. Nope, nope. There we go. The power of sisterhood protects them on re-entry.
Okay, this is getting ridiculous. How do you keep surviving all this? I bet you're trying to sneak up on me right now. Aren't you, Bayonetta?
Meanwhile, a few days later,
for the wicked. But at least she's at peace. Back in the box she came from. And I guess I'm gonna have to find a new racket to line my pockets. No bonus for old Enzo this time. As fucking usual.
You know how it works with witches, Enzo. They make a deal with the devil, and when they die, the devil gets his due. You get sucked down into hell and wandering around scared shitless for eternity. Kinda comes with territory.
Why are you telling me this? Is this not why we are standing here, praying for her soul to rest in peace? I better not be out here catching a fucking cold if these prayers don't mean nothing.
It's nice to think your prayers are worth a damn, isn't it? You made a killing exploiting her. Hell, you never know. She might get lonely and come back to haunt your ass.
Haunt me? Hell can keep her then.
I said I'd never give up chasing you. I just never thought the chase would end like this. Rosemary. You said it was a demon repellent. It might help you on the road ahead.
Not just a big-ass bouquet. Two!
Hey. Hey! Hey, wait a second! What What the hell are they coming down here to get her for?
Of course they'd come for the prize they've been seeking all along.
Holy shit! You're...
It's the same thing she did at the beginning of the game!
The last time I cosplay.
No.
You hear that? That's your cue.
Huh? Will you hurry up? Don't tell me you fell asleep in that thing again.
Hey! What the? You gotta fucking be kidding me! You're telling me she... Un-fucking-leavable!
Morning!
She's fine!
What's shoving me into this filthy old casket? The next time some air holes would be nice. Fewer worms, ideally. Save the chit-chat for later. We've got work to do.
Time for sisterly angel murder. Yeah, Rodan is great.
Extra ingenue?
It has a bit of rosemary. In the language of flowers, rosemary equates to remembrance. Suits me now, doesn't it? Let's dance, boys!
Team Little Angels.
Hooray! I beat the Bayonetta. This game is really hard, and some of the fight designs are bad, but it's a really cool game that I still like a lot in spite of its flaws. Enjoyed watching Bayo 1 more than wanting to play it. Yeah, it's, I don't remember if Bayo 2 is, any better about it. But I have Bayo 2. And I will stream that at some point. I don't think I have the Rodan fight unlocked on my other file. And also, I don't think I'm good enough. My understanding is that you are able to fight Rodan, but it is extremely difficult.
Thank you.
Dang it. Even in the credits, I still gotta engage with this stupid mechanic. What? Aww. I was so close. Just a little bit of damage off. And we broke his new car again! Yeah! Pure plat, baby, let's go! Had to get at least one this stream. It is a very difficult character action game. Some of the fights are bad. But for the most part. Good song. Good game. Fly me to the mute. Will this get me VOD muted? Isn't Fly Me to the Moon fucking... Public whatever? Can't remember words right now. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. I love how this song is playing over Bayonetta just actually doing a pole dance. Like, she's not doing a combat strip tease or anything, she's just actually pole dancing. Now that I think about it, I can't use my normal mashing technique on the Switch Pro controller, so that's gonna be a challenge when I move on to Bayo 2. Oh right, I also need to play Killer is Dead. That's another really good Platinum game. Well, I don't know about really good, but it's interesting. Mwah.
Sega.
Hey, that's not the right Sega screen. What a ripoff. Epilogue Requiem. Oh, I got two pure platinums. Nice.
Bam.
Oh right, no, Killer is Dead is the other one, Grasshopper. Is it? Suda 51. Yeah. I got a bronze overall. I didn't get a stone overall. I'll take it. But I got I got 4 golds. I got 4 silvers. 5 bronzes. 5 stones. Killer is Dead starts tolerable and becomes awful. Yeah, I remember really having to push through towards the end of the game, but the stuff that happens at the end of the game is really cool. Congratulations. You got handguns. I will save. I don't remember any of the levels in particular, except for the last one. Oh, right! Time for the music video. And it's like, this dance here, it's fun, it's stylish, but because of the saxophone, it just makes me think of the, You Are Correct horse saxophone video. Do we want a post-credits scene? Yes. What do we do for it? I have the best idea. Dragon, kick your ass into the Milky Way. It's another game I need to play. I've never played God Hand. So, God Hand is so much. Yeah, it's a lot. Not a Kamiya game. Yeah, like... Oh yeah, the duet! It's by the guy that made Ghostwire Tokyo, right! Yeah, and Vanquish! That's not the guy that, like, the guy that headed the, like, actual development of, Nier Automata, right? It's like there's a handful of big names at Platinum. It's Kamiya, Shinji Mikami, and that the other one.
Bayonetta.
I did it. I beat the game! And I didn't even get that bad a ranking. Mm. I thought that, like, there was a big name at Platinum that worked alongside Yoko Taro. That I'm trying to remember. Right! Shinji Mikami did Evil Within. Yeah, let me try and find the Rodan fight. And I still got another hour. Do I want to play a little more video game with the hour remaining? Start Bayonetta 4. I mean, I got a lot of projects to work on already, but I mean, I could just start making Bayonetta 4 if you really want me to. All right. I found the Rodan fight on YouTube. Oh right, it was the Squeenix fellas that were most of the, like, heads of the of that project. Where is? Okay. There we go. From the boss fight database. Future me is going to hate the way that I'm cropping this.
If you think you've got enough halos to afford it, how about you show me some love? With enough of those shiny little loops, I can get back to the real me, the old me. Let's get this party started. Shit's gonna get real.
You need like a million halos in order to challenge him or something like that. So this is on the Wii U version. Oh wait, hang on. Let me... There we go. Much better. The Infinite One, Father Rodan! Flourish on his health bar is very cool. Rodan's halo is the same as Jubileus. Yep. Yeah, that Wii U slowdown. Oh my god, those attacks are dealing so much damage. Thank you. shit. Is he gonna do it? Nice. That was a hot silver medal.
I never thought a girl would beat my ass so hard, but I gotta admit, I kinda liked it. You win. This time, baby.
Thank you, video. Thank you, boss fight database. Yeah, you could unlock a bunch of Nintendo costumes on the Wii U version. Like, there's a Princess Peach costume, and you can get, like, a Chain Chomp weapon. The Chain Chomp weapon and the Princess Peach costume might be for Bayonetta 2. I know that in Bayonetta 2, you can get a Star Fox costume, I think. Which is fun. Alright, yeah, Yeah, I think I'm just going to wrap things up rather than start another thing and drag out the stream. The Princess Peach one gives your demon attacks Bowser limbs. Oh, that's great. You can get them on the Switch versions. Nice. Star Fox costume turns your guns into R-Wings. Love it. Raid Dura. Okay. Oh god, like, so many people are streaming right now. Right, so, before I send you all off, upcoming streams. Saturday, I'm gonna try and get the cart crew together for another ride. Monday is going to be more Peglin, and maybe some other run-based games. That's kinda what I'm feeling. Maybe it'll be something else, but it'll probably be Peglin and maybe other run-based games. That's my general plan. Next Tuesday will be more Yakuza 5, and then next Thursday and Saturday, my mom's gonna be in town, so probably no streams for those 2 days. So, thanks again to everyone for showing up and hanging out in chat and all that good stuff. Hope you enjoyed Bayonetta, and hopefully I will see you all again on Saturday. Go have a good time with Dura. Later.